Hello everyone, my name is Sumitra Swain. I welcome you all to the UNC Digital Classes. We are studying Introduction to Business, and in today's class we are going to study a new chapter, that is your business activities and the classification of business activities. First, we have to understand that what is business activities. Business activities are the activities or operations those are carried out by a business throughout the year. So when we start a business, we are doing something or we are doing some activities. So all the things we are doing in an organization or in the business, all those things are called as business activities. So those activities can be your making of goods, production of goods or selling of goods, and it can be your providing of services. We have already started that it can be only three type of things. It can be your production of goods, or it can be exchange of goods, or it can be exchange of service. Only three things are there. So whatever activity you may do or whatever activity you may operate, those activity only performed for the purpose of making a profit, because a business is an economy activity. Whatever we are doing here is the main purpose, or the primary objective is to earn profit. It include things like it can be your production, it can be your operation, it can be marketing and administration. So we are going to classify all the business activities into different categories. Okay, so our whole business activity can be categorized into two things. It can be a industry and it can be a commerce. So this is our business, and all the business activities can be divided into industry and it can be your commerce. Under industry, there are three things, that is your primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary again divided into extractive and genetic. Secondary got divided into your manufacturing and construction. And manufacturing again divided into four categories, that is your analytical, synthetic, processing and assembling. Under industry, there are three categories. First is your primary and the second one is your secondary. But there is no categorization of your tertiary sector. Actually, tertiary is nothing else, only the service line. Okay, so when we provide service, that is the tertiary sector in India. Now comes to the part of your commerce. Under commerce, there are two things. First one is your trade and the second one is auxiliary to trade. This auxiliary to trade is also called as your aids to trade. Okay, so TRADE. And this trade is divided into two things, that is first your internal, second is your external. Internal part can be called as your wholesale business or it can be a retail. See, this internal is within the country. Okay, and the external part means which is beyond the country, beyond the region of a country, that is called as external. So this external can be again divided into three things, that is your import, export and interport. Now look into the aids to trade. Aid means when we help. So how we can help to exchange the goods and services, that can be we can take the help of transportation, we can take the help of warehousing, insurance, banking and finance and advertisement. So this is all about the activities which we can perform to do our business. Whatever business you may run or operate, all your activities fall under only these categories of activities. Clear? So now in today's class, we are only going to discuss about the industry, the primary and secondary industry, and different functions or different activities performed in the primary and secondary industries. So first we have to understand that what is industry, because there are two things in business. It can be an industry or it can be a commerce. Okay, so industry means the production of goods for sale by the application of humans or mechanical power. So we can say that industry is the place where the actual production is happening, because commerce means the trade, or means we can say that the exchange of goods. Once the goods are produced or manufactured, then we will think about the commerce. Okay, so first comes that how we will produce or how we will generate the things. It is written that it is concerned with changing a form of goods from any stage from raw material to finished product. We have already known that business is a firm utility. Okay, so we can say that we are doing or we are engaging ourselves in industry where we can change or we are alternating the goods form. Okay, the in the shape or in the size or whatever we can say that there is a changes happening in the under the industry. And the whole stage operates in three stages. It can be your raw material shape, it can be in the stage of work in progress, and the third one, it can be your finished product. Okay, clear? Now we will discuss about the various activities performed under the industry. So this slide is saying about the types of industry. Basically, industry can be divided into two categories. First is your primary, second is your secondary. And sometimes it is also written that the third industry also exists, that is your tertiary industry. Okay, and I have already told you that tertiary means those industry which are engaged in the providing of services, your IT sectors, your educational sectors, all those things also come under tertiary sectors. Okay, first comes your primary industry. The industry which provide basic raw material from natural sources are called as your primary industry. So we can say that the first thing that comes into existence is your primary industry. Here we again categorize this industry into two categories, that is your genetic industry and the second one is your extractive industry. As the name suggests, genetic industry is those industry which are concerned with the breeding, means it can be the reproduction or the multiplying of certain species of plant and animals with the object of earning profit from their sales. We are not producing the plants. Can we produce the plants or we can produce the trees? No, we just can take a branch of that tree or we can put it into the soil and we can grow that. Okay, so here it is saying that we are reproducing the plant or we are multiplying the plant number, means we are plucking the seed and we are growing the plants, yes or no? But we cannot, without seed or without any cutting from the branches of a tree, we cannot manufacture a plant, yes or no? So this is all about genetic industry. It is saying that we are breeding certain species of plants, or we can say here we are dealing with the animals, and at the end the objective is to earn profit. So the examples can be your plant nurseries, poultry farms, cattle breeding farm, fish hatching, forestry, etc. Okay, so if you will look closely about all the examples written here, you are doing nothing, you are just taking care of all the things, means it can be your trees, your plants, your cattle or your animals or the forest or anything. Those are come into the earth or into the nature naturally. You are doing nothing, you are just taking care of them and you are multiplying their numbers and you are selling them to someone. By that activity you are earning profit. Okay, so this is about the genetic industry. The second industry comes under your primary industry, that is your extractive industry. Extract means to take, okay, to find out. So these industry are engaged in extracting useful material from soil. It can be from the soil or it can be your water, it can be air or from the beneath of earth surface. And ultimately you can imagine about the examples. When we are operating a industry where we are doing fishing or mining, or we can say that oil exploration, agriculture means we are putting the seeds and from the earth, and from that we are getting the vegetables. Okay, so whatever these things are, we are just extracting that product from the natural sources. So it is written that in this industry the product gifted by nature and obtained for the benefit of mankind. Under extractive industry, we can say that the things or the product or the material we are getting from the natural sources. Obviously, first thing, that all the things are only to be dependent on the natural sources. Okay, that can be your air, soil, water or anything. Okay, that product we can sell them. We are selling all these things, yes or no? So we can sell these things either in the raw material form, means we can harvest the vegetables and we can sell them directly, or we can convert them, or we can do a modification in the form ओके एंड अगेन वी विल सेल देम. सो इट कैन बी अ रॉ मटेरियल और इट कैन ऑल्सो बी अ फिनिश्ड गुड्स ऑल्सो. बट द थिंग इज दैट ऑल द थिंग्स आर टू बी मेजरली डिपेंड ऑन द नेचुरल सोर्सेस. ओके वी हैव टू कीप दिस इन आवर माइंड. नाउ आफ्टर द प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री हियर कम्स द सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्री. इन द प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री वी आर टेकिंग और वी आर एक्सट्रैक्टिंग द थिंग्स फ्रॉम द नेचर. बट इन सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्री वी आर प्रोड्यूसिंग समथिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑल दोज थिंग्स विच आर फाउंड इन द प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री. ओके इफ यू डोंट हैव जंगल और यू डोंट हैव द फॉरेस्ट और द ट्रीज हाउ यू विल मेक अ टेबल. इज दैट पॉसिबल? नो. सो इन सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्री वी हैव टू टेक द हेल्प ऑफ योर प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री फर्स्ट. सो इंडस्ट्री विच यूज द मेटेरियल प्रोवाइडेड बाय द प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री आर कॉल्ड एज द सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्री. अगेन इन सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्री देयर आर टू टाइप्स, दैट इज योर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड सेकेंड इज योर कंस्ट्रक्शन. अंडर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री, दिस इंडस्ट्री आर कंसर्न्ड विद द प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल एंड सेमी फिनिश्ड प्रोडक्ट इनटू फिनिश्ड प्रोडक्ट. हियर वी आर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग समथिंग. ओके सो वी आर चेंजिंग द शेप और वी आर चेंजिंग और वी आर अल्टरनेटिंग द फॉर्म ऑफ दैट मटेरियल प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द जेनेटिक और इट कैन बी योर एक्सट्रैक्टिव इंडस्ट्री. मीन्स फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री व्हाट मटेरियल वी आर गेटिंग वी आर डूइंग अ मॉडिफिकेशन दैट कैन बी माइनर और मेजर. ओके बट ए लिटिल मॉडिफिकेशन इन द प्राइमरी इंडस्ट्री विद द हेल्प ऑफ मशीन्स और द मैनकाइंड इट विल बी योर सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्री एंड अगेन इट विल बी योर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री. अंडर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री एग्जाम्पल्स कैन बी योर सीमेंट, सुगर, टेक्सटाइल, जूट, एनीथिंग. ओके दिस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री अगेन कैटेगराइज्ड आर फोर पार्ट्स, दैट इज योर एनालिटिकल, सिंथेटिकल, प्रोसेसिंग एंड असेंबलिंग. फर्स्ट इज योर एनालिटिकल. इन एन एनालिटिकल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री ए बेसिक रॉ मटेरियल इज ब्रोकन इंटू सेवरल यूजफुल मटेरियल. सो द एग्जाम्पल कैन बी योर ऑयल रिफाइनरी. इफ यू नो दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड द नेचुरल ऑयल और द ऑयल रिफाइनरी इज परफॉर्म्ड अंडर द सी, वी कैन नॉट डिग एनी ऑफ द अर्थ्स पार्ट एंड वी विल पुट आउट द पेट्रोलियम. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. ओके सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट वेयर द ऑयल इज स्टोर्ड एंड आफ्टर डिगिंग दैट प्लेस और आफ्टर पुटिंग ऑल द मशीनरीज वी विल फाइंड द ऑयल एंड वी विल फाइंड योर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ऑयल दैट कैन बी योर पेट्रोलियम ऑयल और एनीथिंग. नेक्स्ट इज सिंथेटिकल. अंडर सिंथेटिकल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री टू और मोर मटेरियल आर मिक्स्ड. ओके सो देयर आर टू नेचुरल एलिमेंट्स, वी विल कंबाइन देम एंड फ्रॉम दैट वी विल फाइंड आउट अ थर्ड थिंग और वी विल फाइंड एमंग दिस टू पार्ट्स. ओके सो यू कैन टेक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ योर कॉस्मेटिक्स, यू कैन टेक योर सोप, सीमेंट, फर्टिलाइजर, पेंट, एनीथिंग. ओके सो देयर आर सो मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स अवेलेबल वेयर यू विल लुक दैट देयर आर टू थ्री थिंग्स दे विल बी पुट इन टू ए कॉम्बिनेशन और पर्टिकुलर मिक्सचर एंड फ्रॉम दैट वी विल फाइंड आउट और वी विल मैन्युफैक्चर ए न्यू थिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड एज योर सिंथेटिकल. नेक्स्ट इज प्रोसेसिंग. एज द नेम सजेस्ट दैट द प्रोडक्ट और द थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू मैन्युफैक्चर दैट हैव टू फॉलो ए पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस. ओके विदाउट 4, 5, 6 प्रोसेस द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट कैन नॉट बी अचीव्ड. सो इन दिस प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री अ मटेरियल इज प्रोसेस थ्रू वेरियस स्टेजेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन कॉटन टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री कॉटन पासेस थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ स्पिनिंग, वीविंग, डाइंग, ब्लीचिंग एंड देन प्रिंटिंग प्रोसेस. आफ्टर दैट कॉटन इंडस्ट्री प्रोड्यूस अ पर्टिकुलर फैब्रिक और वी कैन से इट प्रोड्यूस अ टेक्सटाइल. ओके नेक्स्ट इज योर असेंबलिंग. हियर वी आर नॉट सेइंग दैट वी आर कंप्लीटली प्रोड्यूसिंग ए थिंग. देयर आर डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ ए प्रोडक्ट, दे आर कमिंग टू अस एंड वी आर असेंबलिंग देम इन ए पर्टिकुलर और सर्टन मैनर और सर्टन वे. ओके टू गेट द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट यू कैन कंसिडर अबाउट द कार्स और ए मोबाइल फोन. ओके इफ यू नो दैट इन कार इंडस्ट्री और द ऑटोमोबाइल सेक्टर व्हाट एक्चुअली हैपन, द इंजिन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय समवन एल्स, द टायर इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय समवन एल्स, द ग्लास, द ब्रेक्स, द म्यूजिक, एवरीथिंग. All the small parts are produced by different companies. They come into one company. And so let's say it is Maruti Suzuki. So Maruti Suzuki will do all the assembling work. And then it will put a sticker of Maruti Suzuki. And we know that the car is of Maruti Suzuki. But if you know that all the parts are from different companies. Okay. Likewise in mobile companies also. The camera is built by someone else, the processor is from someone else, and the Bluetooth is produced by another company, and one company just assemble all the things and sell it in a whole piece, and we know that the phone is from that company. Okay, so it is written that in this type of industry, manufactured company or part are combined together mechanically or chemically to produce a new product. It can be combined either by mechanically or it can be chemically. The examples written here are the manufacturer of radios, watches, automobiles, etc. Okay. And now it is your construction industry. Under the secondary industry, first was your manufacturing industry. Now it is your construction industry. Okay. So as the name suggests that it is engaged in the construction or erection or the fabrication of different type of things, you already know that is your building, it can be bridge, your roads, your dam, canal, etc. They utilize the product of manufacturing industry such as bricks, steel, cement, etc. So what actually happened here, that under the secondary industry, the manufacturing industry produced the bricks or the steel or cement by using different type of process, or it can be different type of chemicals, and what is their finished goods, again it become the raw material for the construction industry, and they use these things to again construct some new things. Okay, so likewise all the activities of all the business or all the industries are interlinked, or they are in a chain system. What is their finished good will be the raw material for another industry. Okay, and also there is a very distinct feature or a characteristics of this industry. In all the industry, the physical goods can taken into the marketplace and they can be sold. And also, the raw material can be purchased and the process can be continued. But in construction industry, what actually happened, that the place where the buildings or the bridge or the what construction is going to be work upon, that is on that particular fixed position, and you have to go to that place with all your equipment and machines, and you have to construct that thing on that particular place. And also after finishing of that thing, the product cannot be moved, or they cannot be physically taken into the marketplace for the selling purpose. And also the product manufactured or construct in the under this industry are very durable. Means if I am building a house, I can say that the building is going to be there without any natural calamities. Okay, so that house is going to be stay there for 50 or 60 years also. The bridge or any canals or anything, they are not here only for 1 year or 2 years. Okay, those temporary things are different thing, but if we are building them for a permanent or very common purpose, then they are very much durable. So with this, I am ending the video lecture class here. If you have any doubt in any part of the section, you can write it in the comment box. I will answer there. Thank you for watching the video and have a good day.